Panthers.
The future. Everyone thinks about it, businesses try to predict it. But does anyone really know what the future holds? If you knew, what would you do differently? How would you prepare? If you're the CEO of a Fortune 500 company, then you're trying to answer these questions and most likely turning to one woman for help. I had the pleasure of sitting down with futurist Faith Popcorn, founder and CEO of the Brain Reserve, at the C-Suite conference in Boston. Since starting her business in the 1970s, Faith has had a 95% accuracy rate when it comes to trend forecasting. She forecasted some of the biggest trends, including bottled water, the transition from film to digital, cocooning, and has recently said that 45% of all jobs will be replaced by robots within the next 10 years. Join me as I take a peek into the mind of a futurist. You've got a very impressive clientele when I look at it.
Thank you.
Allergan, GE, Home Depot, L'Oreal, and a lot more. So how does it work? I've engaged you before in terms of with work
right.
and the activity we've done at a corporate level, but talk to me for the average person out there that's listening or the average business. How does engagement work? I mean, do I hire you? You come and sit in my lobby?
On your lap.
And just think of things.
And take notes.
Yeah.
No.
But how does it work?
So the way it works is that we're retained usually by C-suite, mm-hmm. and they usually have a problem. And, you know, they say, what do we do with these big books? You know, looking forward, we're seeing resistance in our, you know, in our group, in our industry. And we have a 40-step methodology where we crack the problem. But actually, we know what the future looks like. We have a 17 trend bank, Faith Popcorn's trend bank, right? It's been in force since 1972. It's held. You know, little things morph underneath
it. It's like the Dow Jones average.
Exactly.
In terms of the way in which you follow it.
We know what's going to happen. The assignment is about what's going to happen to you.
The brand itself.
Yeah, the brand itself or the company itself. Applied futurism is not that difficult.
Well, I'm intrigued by the model, and so I'm asking a lot of questions because now I'm super intrigued about the way the engagement does. Is it because the company's in trouble that they usually call you, or... Let me ask you another question. Do you see in the 17 things that you do in those trends report, you say, okay, I see something here. Who are the brands? We got to go talk to them.
That's
part of it.
Well, that's part of it. You know, we look at it and say, who's going to be in the most trouble? The food companies.
I'll give you an example. Back when I was a CMO, mm-hmm. you and Ted called.
Yeah.
And said, hey, you know, you're the new guy on the block. You want
to
talk to me.
Right, maybe you'll listen.
Yeah, because the other guys didn't.
Yeah, we went to Kodak way before you, and our assignment was the future of film. Mm-hmm. And we said the future of film, we came back, is digital. And they said, we did not hire you to tell us this. Go away. So then when you came, we heard good things about you. So we, you know, thought we'd try again. Usually, if it means uprooting a whole company to go forward, usually the people there...
It's tough.
It's tough.
This has been Executive Perspectives with Jeffrey Hazlett. I've been talking to the futurist, Faith Popcorn.